to the next and final round, John Roderick, will you say that, oh, for this, I would like all remaining people who would like to play to come up to the stage. All remaining people who would like to play, not you normals. I'm talking about...
Well, now the name of this game, I should preface, I should give you this information so you do not hate John Hodgman more than you already do. The name of this game is Celebrity. And we've already established for the purposes of this cruise that the definition of celebrity is very flexible.
Very fluid. Very fluid.
So, will celebrities come to the stage and pull the duration? You see some celebs down here. What are you celebs doing? You're just basking in your celeb area?
Hold on to this.
He's coming. Ted Leo, this is the one time in your life you will legitimately be called a celebrity.
Let me eat a piece of paper.
Come to the stage. this isn't the 930 Club, man. This is a real theater.
So... especially the host of this show, I'm doing secretarial work while John Roderick starts pitting people against one another. Just announce, dude.
I'm announcing.
Let me keep it together.
I'm announcing that I do not recognize this monarch. I feel he is an antipope.
Alright. These, we are all friends here on the cruise. Take a piece of paper and tear it into four pieces of paper. Well, no. If you need another piece of paper, come tear it off of this script here that I was using earlier. You also won't need pens, which is something I should have thought of. Pens. Is there anyone who can supply a pen? Would you mind? Thank you very much. You'll get this back at the end of the school year. Everyone will need a pen, or at least a couple of you will need to share some pens. Thank you very much. Very much. Very much.
Oh, Dick Grayson as Nightwing.
That's a lot of pens, and we'll leave them here at the edge of the stage. Afterward, you can come collect your pens. Now, the game of celebrity is played a little bit differently in different households. It's a long-time parlor game. I guess it's in the public domain, and that's why we can steal it here tonight. The way we are going to play it is this. Each person will have four slips of paper. Each person will write a name of a celebrity. We'll define that in a moment. On each of those pieces of paper, so a different celebrity on each piece of paper. So let's say, for sake of argument, George Clooney, Elon Musk, I think would count, non-fictional, well-known humans. George Clooney, Elon Musk, I have Martha Washington, and then yourself, because you're all celebrities, and that would make it easier. I don't know what I'm saying.
Famous American.
Yeah.
Famous
American.
Alexander. Yeah. So.
I was waiting for
you
to say
it. I thought I got my wrong. So, the way I would play this game, and which is the way you are going to play this game, is that the name can be any person of renown. It can be a historical or contemporary figure. It cannot be a fictional figure. It can be a person who is known for anything. But bear in mind while you're writing them down that the goal of the game is you will eventually split into teams, and I hope we have an even number of people here. We'll work it out. You will eventually split into teams, and then each one of you will take turns trying to help your team guess the name of the piece of paper after you've pulled it out of the hat. So these will all be pulled and put into a hat. Oh, we need a hat. Evan Schlepp? No. I don't want to take away your manhood. Really? Oh. That's your throne. I mean, that's your crown. Oh my goodness. Thank you, Evan. This is a great sacrifice.
In order to even the score, I will play with the team on stage.
Very good. Then you will need to tear up a piece of paper and write down four names.
Wait, you've got the newlyweds on opposing teams?
This is terrible.
Yeah, straight up, I'm just going to write lesbian celebrities. The only one who can guess it is Rhea. Like, I'm already deep on Alison Bechdel. Go fuck yourselves if you don't know my hero.
Do your best. So, what will happen is, you will put all of these sheets of paper into the same hat, both of you. The hat will go from one team to the other. Each time it moves to your team, let's say it's your team, one of you, determined how, some way or the other, will pull a name out of the hat and attempt to help your team to guess that name, with the intent of getting as many names guessed within a 1 minute period as possible. There are three ways in this game to help your team guess the name that you hold in your hand, and we do them by rounds. The first round will be simple $25,000 pyramid style. You can describe the name of the person that you are holding in your hand. So, for example, if it is Martha Washington, you would say, the wife of George Washington. A terrible way to define what I'm sure was a whole human being, but there you go.
You can't say Washington.
But I would have been out, you're absolutely right, because you can't say the actual name. Nor can you get tricky and use rhyming, slang, or anything else. You can describe the person. So you could say the whole human being who happened to also be married to the first president of the United States. And that would be, and then anyone on the team could yell at Arthur Washington. And then you go on to the next one, and so on, all within a 1 minute period. Then it goes over, once your minute is done, it goes over here, you do the same thing. Back and forth, minute by minute, racking up names, each of those names is a point, until the hat is empty. Then we tabulate the points for that round to move on to the second round. The second round, you do the same thing again, but this time, it's everyone's favorite, charades. You have to do charades, and it's terrible, and it's awful. Here's where it really hurts your team, is that charades, everyone hates, I'm sorry, but it's easy to get stuck on names in charades, and you cannot pass. So if you can't do it, you might just run out that minute without doing it, and then your team takes a hit. So that's the tough one. May I trust that we all know the basic sounds, likes, and whatevers? All right, that'll come to us. Oh, boy. Yes, John.
John, now that I understand that there is charades involved, I would like to recuse myself.
Fine. That's fine. I will select... Were you the evening out?
I was evening out. Ted wants to leave the stage, but I don't think we should let him.
Ted, do you want out?
Make Robert do it!
You both are required to play. Bear in mind that the larger the team, the less often you will be in play. Most of the time, we're all just hanging around having a good time.
Depending on your definition.
No, John Roderick is going to play. Does she really wants to play? No, thank you, Andrew. Too kind. But John Roderick needs this in his life. He needs to commit to it and stick with it.
Thank you, Andrew.
I love you.
Tough love.
I'm trying to get this. Second round of charades. Go through all 30 names. Everyone's hearing the names. You're starting to get familiar with them. You're starting to remember what they are. Your team grows its own weird subculture of tricks and hints and slang. And the third round, you do it again, but this time you can only say one word. So, Martha Washington, you might say. Sea monkey to be a scorekeeper. Here, gotcha. And you will be. Is that Kendra?
Yeah.
Oh, hi. Yeah, you got to come up here. You're gonna be the hat mover back and forth. Yeah. Okay. Good. And you, an assistant scorekeeper.
You need Michael Ian Black up here to shuffle these. Thank you. One and a half laugh.
Do we have team names? First of all, what is your name, sir?
Josh.
Josh is the scorekeeper, and Kendra is the assistant scorekeeper and hat mover. Do we have team names? We have a team name over here. Josh, will you collect the team name?
We are the Rhea Butchers.
Team, this team, do you have a name?
Yeah, the Real Rhea Butchers.
Yeah!
I love this game.
John Roderick, is the hat big enough?
The hat is, well, you know, we had a lot of variation. People, some people thought that they should make their piece of paper as big as they could, and some people thought they
In fairness, we weren't told what we were doing with the pieces of paper.
So, a lot of variation in size.
Also, some of us just start out with big paper and can't do a lot about it.
That's Big Willie.
Ready?
All right, it's ready. Remember, there are small pieces and big pieces, everyone, so...
So, in this case, what I would like, we're going to go... here first.
That seems fair. On behalf of the Real Rhea Butchers, thank you for putting yourself in great danger to do that.
That's fine. Anything for votes. Now, have you selected someone who will draw first?
Matt Gourley.
Matt Gourley will be going first.
How long is this game?
I'll do the timing on this one because
okay,
because you're playing.
Yeah.
And we gotta go fast. All right, ready, Matt Gourley? Go.
He makes popcorn, has glasses, he's in the room.
Or no red carpet.
Right. All right. Oh, Mr. President, happy birthday. all right. He was in the original motion picture of MASH, and he was also in Philip Marlowe. No, his last name. Oh, yeah, cool.
That's right. Okay. All right. He's Forrest Gump.
Okay.
Yep. Oh my God, she's a rhythm and blues artist. She was in a Steve Martin movie. She became an actress. She's royalty. Her first name is the female royalty. Yes. Okay. All right. Host of Price is Right.
Bob Barker.
Yeah. No, Bob Barker's right. Okay. Robert Ebert or Ebert's partner.
What's
that's right. All right. FDR's wife.
Eleanor Roosevelt.
Yes.
Also a human being.
Wrestler in the 80s. Big handlebar mustache was racist.
Yes.
Okay. First female astronaut.
Sally.
Yes. Pink Floyd, the frontman. Yes.
First
oh my God. Oh God. Her name is something that you tie your shoe with.
You're out. You're not. Put it back in. Well, yeah.
Wow.
Josh, Caroline, Kendra, bring it on over. We gotta get moving. Quarter four. Jim, go to start.
She just got a Super Bowl. She just did the Super Bowl halftime show. He just got out of the race. He asked people to clap. Exactly. Oh, really? You folded? Come on. Dear God. The last name is the same name as a porn star of the 70s. The first name is, No, go for the deep throat.
Can we pass?
Oh, can we pass in this round?
No, you can't pass.
Are you kidding me? Oh, my God. Muppets. There you go. Boom. He sold the wine before its time. Citizen Kane.
Orson.
There you go. Cowboy. Conservative.
That's it.
What?
It's your ruling. You're the bailiff. They got it.
Oh, is this bailiff also?
Well, just answer.
Oh, he got it right at time.
So. All right, good. You got it.
Yeah.
You got it. I'm using a machine to count it. Hey, Will.
We have to use those again.
Pick up your trash, dude. Come on. We need to use those again. If you disrespect the slips again, you get a 5-second penalty. Don't diss the slips. 5-second penalty.
This is Artemis all over again.
Can we nominate him as our next guesser?
All right, ready? All right, same thing. We keep going until the hat's empty. Here we go, and go. Well, well, stop it. You understand how important it is not to shut things out. This is the game we're playing. Oh, I thought you were yelling at the name of the golfer. Well, that microphone isn't going to help you. I give you, because of my error, I give you your full minute back, all right? I'm not a villain. Go.
George's brother, terrible governor of Florida.
Jeb Bush.
Yes, and this is, of course, silent film star. She was beautiful. She worked. She had a bowl haircut. And James L. And right, and her first name is, and it's Kevin Sue's daughter is named after her. And geez,
Louise Brooks.
And this is, of course, the theory of evolution guy.
Charles Darwin.
Yeah, and then, of course, we have the guy who rides around on horses. He's the Russian guy. Yeah, no shirt guy. But that's all, folks.
Porky Pig.
Right, and the guy that did his voice was
like, Who put Porky Pig in there?
No, it's...
What was the correct answer? Well, yeah, I just paused. What was the correct answer?
Mel Blanc.
Yes.
Resume.
Okay, and she is an actress. She was in The Sense of Sensibility, and yeah, that's her. And then this is folded up, and he wrote The Martian Chronicles. And this is, she was with the Captain and... Yeah, what's her whole name?
All right, you're done.
Yeah, turns out she has a first name. Yeah, that's right.
I'll allow Tony to kneel, that's fine. You guys had a rough stop there. Here's what I want to do. Can I get a stage helper, please, to set up mic stands here and here, or Kendra, you can just grab this one. So folks don't have to hold the mic while they're pulling. I think that'll work. Josh, will you tabulate? Well, you can tabulate at the end of the round. Hold on to your slips of paper. We'll tabulate at the end of the round. Great. And let's put one of those microphones and bring this out here. All right, who's up over here?
Oh boy.
Get ready, get set, go.
Oh shit. Okay, The Shining.
Yeah.
And he's over there. And diminutive name for him, Star Trek.
Will be.
This guy, okay, he's gonna kill you with a sword. What's the action? Sort of, but more real than that. And his first name has a consonant blend.
Vlad the Impaler.
That's right! Star Wars. Director of. This guy made music, and I don't know what any of it is, but his last name sounds like a pasta that my people eat.
That's right.
Oh, she's a big lady, she's a cross-dresser, and she's in... Yep. Also, single ladies and field formation. Beyonce.
All right, that's it, you're done.
I have a question. I'm just... Because I don't think it was intended when they named me. How is my name diminutive?
Short for little.
Only has one L.
Oh, sure, of course. That's interesting. That's the diminutive form. But
it's a lowercase W.
I was saying that we have been shaming you for the last couple of hours with the diminutive name of your name.
I'll allow it because okay. You're right and everyone else is wrong.
That's right.
As long as...
I wasn't participating, but these dicks.
So, Quick point of order, we're at 4:54 here now. This is going long. There's no way we're going to be able to play round two or three. So the rest of this is all the marbles. We'll continue now going forward, as is, what, how many are there? Yeah, that's probably, we have plenty, there are a lot of names. So we're gonna go until we empty the hat, and then whoever has the most slips wins. Do you know where we are now, Josh?
Well, right now, the Real Rhea Butchers are at 20 points.
20 points for the Real Rhea Butchers.
We're at 14 points.
14 points. For Real Rhea's, you're up. Who's guessing? And I'm going to be really sharp on the clock here. So let's go.
She was in Fried Green Tomatoes. Some Kind of Wonderful. There we go. He was, oh God, he's in Star Trek, Darkness, bad guy, Sherlock. Yes. He was in Dune, and somebody name checked him by name.
Sting.
Yes. Not Ginger Roberts, the partner. But his answer there. Annie Hall, vests, gloves, speaking. Four weddings and a funeral.
I got it wrong.
Yes. Oh God. Alexander
Hamilton.
But a different name at the beginning.
Oh no.
Cyrus the Great.
Ken, wait a minute.
Did I say the?
No, I mean, you were already out of time by the time you said no another.
Oh, okay.
So I don't think that one can go in, I'm afraid. That's not too.
Wait, what's happening?
Yeah, you have to put that back in the hat. You just dropped it right there. Okay. I'm the judge, Kendrick.
I was in the zone. I don't even know what's happening.
It's happening. Good job. Let's go. Who's up?
Right.
John Roderick!
Drake! Make him do it on screen!
Alright. Here we go.
Go!
He was a revolutionary black leader.
Malcolm X!
He was Johnny Carson's sidekick. He was a king of ancient Greece and times. And he had a name that was the last name of a pop star who used to be a country and western kid star. She was a young kid star, and now she's a pop star who takes her clothes off, but it's always artistic. And Cyrus, he's enormously, he's wonderful.
Cyrus the Great!
Thank you! No, I didn't. She used to jump motorcycles, American motorcycles.
Here, look at him.
He had just made the greatest pop album of all time. He says, thank you. Let's see. I have no idea who this is, but he is a ruler, and his name is a
that's time.
British motorcycle.
That's time. Put it back in.
We're number two!
Is that one?
You missed the hat.
Oh, I don't want this to have to go to the Supreme Court now that it's completely 4-4. You know what I mean? Whew. All right, here we go. Who's up over here? Real Rhea Butchers, Ted Leo, drawing, go.
This was the one that John was just doing. It's my thing. I wrote it down. He was a ruler.
Hoist on your own petard.
He ruled briefly a portion of Central America that this is in the 19th century. It was a brief another attempt. I'm killing us. Okay, take the last name, put a kind of ruler in front of it.
King Norton.
Bigger than a king. Emperor Norris. She was in Chitty Bang Bang. He directed Star Wars.
George Lucas.
It's another one of mine. Why am I such an idiot?
He's the last leader of the Lakota Sioux tribe.
That's time. Can you put that back in the hat, Trevor? Trevor, ladies and gentlemen. Who's up for Rhea Butchers? Scalzi, you have 1 minute. Go.
Okay. It is a Native American.
Symbol.
No, and it relates to something that happens in the sky when there is moisture. And it would be a color. Close.
Sitting. No.
And the,
sitting
the, the color would be like this.
Red.
Wow.
Yes.
Wow. That's an amazing question.
All right.
Emperor Norton and Red Cloud.
What's love got to do with its star? Okay. Short people got no reason.
Randy Newman.
All right. I don't know who the hell this is. But the last name is appropriate for the last for a TV show with the word girls in it. And first name is appropriate for the a rabbit. So first name. No, try another one. Famous one. What the fuck?
That's time.
No,
you can't show it.
We didn't know.
That's happened. That's an unearned. That's an unearned point. I'm gonna decide what to do with that later. Who's going up? Janet Varney is up. And go.
He's James Bond.
Sean Connery!
Yes. Choose the facts of life.
Mendicum.
What? She was the only one. Captain Kirk.
Lieutenant.
Yes.
Really? Take a moment.
She's back. She was in Fried Green Tomatoes.
Married to Romance.
Yes. She was married to Ricky.
What?
Ricky. Yes. Female wrestler.
Ronda Rousey.
Yes. I'm afraid I don't know who this is, but the first one is she's crazy. She thinks there's an afterlife, multiple lives.
Shirley.
Yes, that's her first name.
Shirley.
First name.
Shirley
Chisholm. Yes. A Hispanic, beautiful, voluptuous. Yeah, you got it. No, it's like Blake and Louise, the show, the movie. Rhymes with that. Her first name.
They got it. That's time though. That's got it. I got just under the wire. All right, here we go.
I just have to say, Cameron and Zito and I.
There are only two left.
Oh, we can't.
Go for it.
I'm just so.
And there are two left. Here we go.
Oh, my goodness. I don't know who this person is. The pork, Mexican food, the way they cook it, it's they put it in tacos.
Taco Pastorius.
There we go.
Respect.
There's only one left, and I have enough time to do it. Also, I wish I... Why am I so terrible at some things? When you take time off, what do you call that? Another word. Like Christmas. Yes. That's the last
holiday.
Name. There we go. Thank you.
Have a nice day, ladies and gentlemen. The hat goes back to Evan Schlatter. Josh is tabulating. Team Rhea Butchers, you have someone who can speak for you now, a little after game interview?
Oh, I wanted to just ask Ted Leo, what the fuck you think a celebrity is?
I think Ted, I think, was under the impression that he would not have to guess his own secret. Real Rhea Butchers, team, obvious team captain.
Of course, yes.
How do you feel it went today?
I feel like it went really well. I also want to point out, because I don't know if everyone heard, but both Cameron Esposito and I put in Mary Stuart Masterson.
Yeah!
Not quite sure if we both put in Angela Bassett or not, but Angela Bassett was in their choice.
If you were to prevail, what do you think was your team's secret of success?
Being the real Rhea Butchers.
All right. That's
exactly what it is.
Let's go over here to the Rhea Butchers.
Jean Grey.
Yes.
Star of stage, screen, and everything.
Yeah.
Great show last night.
Thank you. Yeah. Brought that energy here.
Tell me how it felt to play today. You feel good about how you guys played?
Felt amazing. I think the thing that we weren't expecting was another team to show up. So, yeah, we were solid, and then they were here. So. I also want to give it up for Matt Gourley, who really fucked us. Yeah.
How do you?
He's thrown a lot of heat up top, and I think it became impossible to come back from his antics and silly voices.
That's true. He's a strong player, that's for sure. Well, Josh, do we have the final tally?
We do have a final score.
Are you confident in your tally?
Yes.
Josh, will you name, please, the runner-up? Yeah, that's a good idea. You deserve it.
The runner-up with 24 points are the Rhea Butchers.
We're number two! Okay. You strive to be number two! That's right! Underdogs!
And that would mean the winners. Josh, will you declare it, please?
The winners with 38 points.
It's not even a real number.
Is, of course, the real Rhea Butcher.
The real Rhea Butcher! Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to stand all day. Keep the slips, please. Put them back. Keep the slips. Don't throw them away. They might come into play later. Somehow, someday, we may play this game again all the way through. But for now, that is your 21st century definition of celebrity game night. I'm John Hodgman for your host, John Robert. There's John Stiles, and there's Kelly Sukakani, Cameron S. Media, Aaron Schletter, Dean, Solomon, and DeBoja, and Bill, and the winners. Everybody, we love you. Go to dinner. Go see Michael Ian Black tomorrow at 10 a.m. It's in your schedule. He's going to read from his book, and it's going to be great.
Okay. And,